good day. It'd be me again. I thought about making something today. I guess I will. It's snowing here. It's minus 6 centigrade. I think that's 21 degrees Fahrenheit. A little warmer than it was yesterday. Or is that a little colder? A little warmer, I guess. But it's snowing. Today's what, 11th? Sunday. Day of rest. I got any wind and stuff in this one? I don't know. I guess not. Thought this had sound with it, but I guess I don't. Just the snow falling. Anyway, I thought maybe I would show you a few things. I found this in my travels today. Still talk about the paranormal shit. But just talk, no do. Anyway, I run across this. And the guy that posted this claims he thinks it's a fake. It's a Photoshop. Well, it could be, and it might not be. See this old lady here in the window? Bent over, you know, hunchback, old lady with white hair. You know, there she is. Well, they say it's a ghost. Now, the story on this is, this old lady passed away. And the house got sold, and the new owners of the house started renovations on the house. As you can see here, this is an addition on the main house. You can tell with the flashing along the white clapboard side there. And they're ripping the roof off, right down to the bare wood, which is the way to do it. It used to be they'd put one roof right over the top of another, you know, shingles over shingles. Sometimes there'd be three layers of shingles on there. They don't do that no more. They strip it right down. So they'll strip that right down to the wood and put new tar paper and then the shingles. And sometimes along the lower edge here by the eaves troughs, they'll put a layer of rubber up so high. So if your eaves troughs freeze over, it won't destroy the lower boards there in the house. It won't make it leak. You won't get no leaks. But anyway, enough of that roof crap. Anyway, this guy took this picture. Somebody took this picture. And they claimed that this old lady here is a ghost. Because she died 3 months before this picture was taken. So, if it is a ghost picture, it's a wonderful one. You know, they always say that ghosts are just transparent wisps of smoke. And they don't have no legs, and they float. And sometimes they look just like they did in life, except they're transparent, and you can see through them. And then there's other accounts of people seeing ghosts, and they look just like you or me. They're completely, completely solid. Sometimes they just blink in, and they're there, and then they blink out, and they're gone. Other times they fade in, and they're there, and you see them, and they look just like you or me, and then they fade out, and they're gone. So, I guess nobody really knows how a ghost is supposed to look. I mean, it can look all kinds of different ways and still be a ghost. So, if that's true, and this is like a solid rendition of a ghost, that's a great one. That's really a great picture. So, I came across that, and it's up to you to make up your own mind. But it looks like a great picture to me. It looks like I can just picture this old lady roaming this house, you know? oh, boy. Well, that's that. I had to show you that. Now I have my last little chit-chat I had, streaming. I was talking about movies, and I was talking about the one I watched with Ben-Hur. It's Ben-Hur 2016 with Morgan Freeman in it. And he's great in here. Jack Houston. Some of these I can show you a little bit of the trailer. Hopefully I won't get flagged for it. But one never knows, you know, I might get flagged for it and have to take the video down.
You wash ashore, shackled. You are an escaped prisoner. How long were you a galley slave?
5 years.
What is your name?
Judah Ben-Hur. My family was one of the most respected in Jerusalem.
Misala, you'll always be my brother. I'm an orphan your father took in.
Until the Romans came.
Subversion will be met!
Well, his brother there joined the Roman Legion. His half-brother. The guy his father took in. He always treated him like a brother. As far as you were concerned, they were brothers. They grew up together. Well, he ran off and joined the Roman Legion, became a big shot.
With crucifixion!
Down with the Romans.
Love your enemies. God is love. Yep.
That was God right there. The carpenter. Let me back up.
Subversion will be met with crucifixion!
Down with the Romans.
Love your enemies.
See him working the wood? The carpenter. That's Jesus. But
God is love. He has a path for you.
If he's already decided my path, how am I better off than a slave?
Why don't you ask God? And then we were betrayed.
They were betrayed. And his brother sent them all off to be killed. I don't want to tell you anymore. I don't want to ruin the movie for you, but it's very good. I really liked it. Really enjoyed it.
By my own brother.
No, we've done nothing wrong.
Rome's calling for blood. I have to give them something.
Where are you taking him? Only love.
There's Jesus putting a hairy eyeball on that Roman soldier.
The world you live in is Rome. Their laws.
First from Eli.
Their power. You cannot defeat them in the streets.
My family, they deserve justice for what's happened to them.
Should have stayed away.
You should have killed me.
I will.
You're alive, Judah. Jesus showed you kindness when no one else would.
There is another way.
So there you have it. I'll probably get flagged for showing that. I turned my meditation off. I might not. That was a good movie. Now, this next one, I don't think I can play any of this because they're playing Queen's song in the background. And that's, if I play this, it's going to get flagged automatically. I know it is. So, I don't believe I'm going to. I'm going to turn the sound off. That way I won't get flagged. I hope. But this is a Suicide Squad. That's the crazy lady there. Will Smith. That guy's like a fire starter. Will Smith was like an assassin for hire. A super shot. Super duper. Sniper. That alligator guy they found in a sewer. She's just plain crazy. Oh, I gotta play this part where she's talking. I don't think there's any queen in the background. Listen up, she's crazy.
That guy shoots people. He's a crocodile and he eats people. He burns people. You're possessed by a witch. And she's just crazy.
What was that? I should kill everyone and escape? Sorry. The voices. I'm kidding. That's not what they really said.
This is the...
So, Queen's in there planning. That's an invitation to get my video flagged. But it's a good movie. Of course, you gotta like violence. That's what it's all about. So, when I'm violent, shoot 'em up, beat 'em up. There's the Joker. I don't know what the Batman has to do with this, but Batman's in here too, and the Joker's in here. I don't follow the Batman comic book series, so I don't know. But apparently, this has something to do with Batman comic book series, I guess, because Batman is in here, Joker's in here, and that assassin there, that woman with the katana, I don't know what she's got to has to do with it either, or the alligator guy in the sewer. I may hell have something to do with like I said, the Batman series. But it's a good movie. It's a crazy movie. It's non-stop action. It's just non-stop. So if you like that kind of movie, you'll like this one. I'm sure you will. I did. So that's The Suicide Squad. Ah, 12 minutes. And two more to go, yeah. This next one is kind of strange. I'll play this one in its entirety here. I don't think anything will happen with this one. This is called Miss Peregrine's
There's a place I go
Home for Peculiar Children. And it's pretty good too. You gotta like weird stuff now. I mean, you know, you gotta like fantasy type stuff. If you do, then you'll probably like this. I did. And it's just around the bend. There's a new world coming. This one's coming to an end.
How did you?
Nothing like blowing the water out of the room.
It's my peculiarity. If I show you the rest, you have to promise not to run away.
Jake, right on time. Miss Peregrine, delighted to meet you.
He's invisible.
Of course.
Those two twins, now they're the weirdest of the bunch. I haven't figured out what the hell they do yet, but they are, I think it showed in there at one time, but I can't remember, but they're the craziest looking ones of the bunch.
What's known in common parlance as peculiar.
Claire, why aren't you eating?
She's embarrassed in front of Jake.
Don't be.
Because our abilities don't fit in the outside world. We live in places like this, where no one can find us.
Jake, come and play.
I knew you.
She's a strong one. The one before that, where she was doing her hands on the ground, she was making a huge carrot, ends up being about 6 foot long, comes popping up out of the ground, and this little one here that's so strong, she grabs the carrot and carries it into the house. And then in the next scene in the house, she shows them eating, and they got big giant slices of carrot. They're like a foot in diameter.
You're one of us when you were born. It's time for you to learn what you can do.
But I'm just ordinary.
No, you're not. You were born to protect us.
Oh, no, there's the famous actress in it, and I can't think of his name. He's in all the insurance commercials.
When you were born, it's time for you to learn what you can do.
Why can't I think of
his name? I'm just ordinary.
No, you're not. You were born to protect us.
Why can't I think of his name? Oh, well. You know who it is.
Promise me one thing. Look after them, Jake.
I promise.
There's a new world coming.
So that's that. That was a good movie. I liked that real well. So I'm recommending that if you haven't seen it. And I guess I got one more here. Ben-Hur, Suicide Squad, Mrs. Peregrine's Home for the Peculiar Children, and this one here. This one I watched yesterday by the makers of Evil Dead. It's a horror movie. Actually, it's a thriller horror movie. And I don't know how much of this I'm going to show you. But it's about a blind man. It's about a group of thugs that break into his home. Because they read about he got like a $600,000 settlement or something from something. He's a ex-Marine and he had this $600,000 settlement, and these thugs want the money, and they figure it's going to be easy because he's blind, and they break into his house, and they find out they bit off more than they could chew.
We messed up to rob a blind guy, isn't it?
Just because he's blind don't mean he's insane, bro.
Right there.
How many of you are there?
Man, I just let me go, please.
Shoots his ass dead. That's all I'll show you. That's all I'm going to show you. I'm rotten. But that's damn good, too. That's a damn good one, too. So, preview of a four movies maybe you did or did not know about that I've watched here in the last few days and found they were really good. They're worth the watch. Ben-Hur was really good because it was sort of this story and stuff was interspersed with the Bible. Jesus is in there a few times. Shows him on the cross. Anyway, I liked that one real well. A lot of action in that. Suicide Squad is just pure action. Fantasy. Mrs. Peregrine's is a lot of action and fantasy. And that's more or less what I like is action type fantasy movies that I'm drawn towards. That and paranormal movies, of course. I don't watch too many horror movies. But this Breath, Don't Breathe, was not really a per se horror movie, but it's got a lot of horror in it. I liked them all. What more can I say? Thanks for stopping in. This was a little review by me of three or four movies. And that's all I have for you today. And a picture of a ghost, or maybe not a ghost. It's up to you to decide. Anyway, that's all I got for you today. Thanks for watching. Thanks for being my friend. Thanks for supporting me. and toodaloo. Hello, everybody, again. I'm going to tack this on to the end of my movie here. I wanted to say, I don't know if you noticed, but I changed the name of my channel again. Back before I started this paranormal stuff, I used to follow all the beard boards. Beards, yes, beards. And I was well known on all the beard boards. I probably still am if I was ever to get back on them again. Well, that's where I used to spend all my time before making YouTube videos. I used to be on the beard boards. And at that time, I was known as Moses the Great White because of the beard, the Great White beard. Not, you know, using that has gotten me in trouble because they think it's racist, but it has nothing to do with being white or black. It's the Great White. It's a reference to my beard, you know. And then people hear the Great White and they think it's about a shark. So anyway, I changed the name of my channel to Moses the Great White's World. That's what it's going to be from now on. That one other thing I wanted to tell you, I was talking about my friends on, a live stream, and I pointed out this out to a few of you that I was ordering me a new cross, and this is a crucifixion cross. Has a Benedictine medal in the center of it, and of course it's a crucifix. And it has all the things you need to ward off evil. And I'm going to say it's quite large. It's black chrome. It's quite large. It's about 3 inches long. But man, I really love it. $25 and best $25 I ever spent. I'm really, really happy with it. It's a beautiful cross. So I just wanted to add that in to the end of my video. So from now on, you're going to be, this is going to be called The Great White's World. So thanks, toodaloo, once again, toodaloo.